I can't believe my wife said no to Banana Dog. Update, I went back for Banana Dog. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my goodness. Hey guys, what is going on? What is shaking and baking? Welcome back to Supplies. I am your host with the most, and today we're going to be looking at some Made Me Smile subreddits. But before we get into all that, I do hope that this video makes your guys' day and makes you smile because you're a special person. Anyway, let's get right into some Make Me Smile memes, and hopefully you'll be able to smile along too. Faces of rescue dogs after they found a human buried in snow during the training session. Look at that top right one. It's like, oh, I found human. And then the bottom left one's like, oh, there you are, human. And then the bottom right one's like, oh, yes, I found you, human. This man stood near the Olympic Village almost every morning with his sign. Somebody give him a medal. Good morning, athletes. Even if you don't get a medal, you're still the best. So believe in yourself. Oh, now that's encouraging. See, this is why I sometimes like the people of Japan. They're so nice. There is a quote from Bert when he says he's known Big Bird since he was a little bird, and the thought of it makes my heart cry, so here's that. Oh, they made a little baby Big Bird. Oh my gosh, that is, and look. Oh, Bert, he's so young. Oh, probably less angry too. The sweetest thing you'll see on the weekend. Oh, Big Floof and Little Floof. Look at how cute they are cuddling together. My mom and I took a trip to Florence, and at one of the restaurants, the olive oil they served with the bread was incredible, and she told our waiter. So, he absolutely beamed and whipped out his phone. Turns out, he and his family grew the olives that made the oil themselves. He was showing us the pictures from his orchard like a man showing off pictures of his firstborn grandkid. Oh my gosh, that is so nifty. I mean, I would too. If it was something like if I was growing oranges and someone's like, oh, this is the best orange juice, I'd probably do the same thing too. I don't blame the guy. Hey dad, nice sneakers. Let's see, texting the dad, can you do me a favor? Can you get me a new pair of sneakers on Amazon Prime and I'll pay you for them size 12? You pick them out, okay? Yes. Or should I ask Shannon? Go on Amazon and pick out a pair, I'll get them. You want, you pick them? I don't know, what kind you like? Sneakers that you would say, hey dad, nice sneakers. Ah, clever. My 27-year-old coworker's ties are always too short, and today he confided he doesn't know how to tie a tie. His dad pre-tied all his ties before he died. I offered to adjust it for him, and he was so happy. He asked if he brought all his ties to work, and I will adjust those for him too. Oh, that is so cute. I love it. That is such a good friend, seriously. I would definitely do the same if I had a friend like that. I hope this hamster will make your day better.
Oh, cute little chubby teeth, his little tiny smile, and his little hands. He's got some cute paws.
Since I started my new job about a month ago, I noticed one of my coworkers gets treated like an outcast. So, I made a point to befriend him. Today, he came to my office, handed me a gift card, and awkwardly goes, thank you for treating me like a person. Dude, I might be crying. Oh, come on. That is so sweet. See, this is why you need to be friends with people you haven't met yet. Faith in humanity restored, hashtag kindness matters. Okay, I guess we have a newspaper clipping, maybe some sort of magazine, not sure. Comes all the way from England, says, thank you to the man who gave me 20 pence in the car park at West Middlesex Hospital last Tuesday morning when I found myself short for parking. Thank to you, I was able to see my father alive for the last time. He died that afternoon. Man, I might be tearing up right now. How cute is this baby goat? Tiny floof thing. Oh my goodness. Look at this little guy. I bet he hopped so beautifully and just. My sister came home from school one day and asked me to take her to the library so she could get books on sign language. She said there was a new kid at school who was deaf and she wanted to be friends with him. Today, I stood beside her at her wedding watching her sign I do. Oh, come on. Y'all are really gonna make me cry. That's so emotional. Was waitressing on a party of 12 and they asked if I would take the picture and I said, sure. So I go to take the picture and the guy goes, 1, 2, 3, Emily is pregnant, and everyone's faces were priceless and I might have shed a tear. Now that is how you tell the family you got a kid. That is so cool. The dining table at our rental house is glass. This is what I see for the entire meal. Oh, come on, just feed him just one slice of bacon, something. I mean, maybe not so much chocolate and ice cream, but come on, there's got to be something he can eat. My grandfather always had candy in his pockets. One time when I got real sick and I was hospitalized, my dad told him not to give me candy. He pulled out his pockets to show he hadn't even brought any, and I got real sad. But as soon as my dad walked out of the room, he then proceeded to take off his hat and had two chewy chocolate candy toffees and two orange Fanta toffees. And I'll never forget the happiness and surprise I felt at that one moment in my entire life. And everyone said, "Aww." I hid under the bed to scare my boyfriend while he was in the bathroom. And when he came out, he saw I was gone, and I watched him all excited and run in the closet and wait to scare me. I was sitting under my bed crying, laughing. Oh my god. Oh, this is great. Oh man, I love the chemistry these two people have. That's so cool. I have this huge ex-military biker guy neighbor who is like 80% handlebar mustache and has a ponytail halfway to his butt, and gave him and all his huge biker friends all have tiny dogs and special motorcycle safe seats for them. Oh, now that's adorable. And my favorite thing is when they all come roaring in on their bikes and take their tiny dogs out of their little studded leather safety carriers. Oh, I'm just imagining how cute that is. And there's this loud cacophony of kissy sounds and full-blown baby noises like, "Was that fun, sweetie?" and "Who's my handsome boy?" Now talk about a 180 twist. You can't say that bikers don't have any emotion or feeling. I mean, seriously, how cute is that? That did put a smile on my face. Four generations. Wow. That is so cool. Got the whole family together. I hope that kid does live long enough to see the grandfather, basically his great-grandfather. I can't draw, but my daughter asked me to draw her a dragon because she thinks I can do anything. So, I did my best, and after I gave it to her, she walked over and hung it on the fridge. And now I'm just sitting here beaming because my daughter really thinks I'm fridge-worthy. Oh, that is so adorable. The boy that I nanny for just asked me where I work, and I didn't have the heart to tell him their parents pay me to hang out with him, so now they think I work in Oh my god. That's funny. My dog accidentally takes part in half marathon after mom lets her out to pee, finishes seven. Wait! I mean, wait, where'd she go? Where'd she go? Wait, where'd you get that medal? My seatmate on a flight is a 6-year-old little girl who started our trip with, "I'm going to talk to you randomly, so you need to be prepared, okay?" Well, at least they're giving a heads up instead of randomly like, "My dad," like, what? This story warms my heart. Back in 1997, Princess Diana met Angolan minefield survivor Sandra Tigia and arranged a prosthetic for her. 22 years later, Prince Harry reunited with Sandra, who is now 38 years old, married with a daughter, and named her daughter Diana. Oh, that is super inspirational. God, that does make you smile. Was on my way to being a first-gen college grad, and then my parents graduated 5 months before me. So proud, son. Well, I'd be like, "Wait, how'd you guys finish before me?" I go to the same gas station every day after work for beer and burritos. Today, when I asked for my burritos, the guy said they're hot. I knew you'd be here, so I made a fresh batch. And that's the most beautiful thing anyone's done for me in a while. Yeah, that's actually pretty nice. My dad was looking at me like this for 5 minutes until I looked down at his plate. Pac-Man! Oh. Having a conversation with my grandma with Alzheimer's. Me. It was nice seeing you. Grandma. It was nice remembering you. Me. You remember me? Grandma. I don't remember your name, but I remember that I love you. Oh, that's so wholesome. Now everybody always brags about their favorite actor or actress doing great job in this movie or that movie, but Sign of the Dawn, he ended up throwing out a little bit of a love to... We're talking about range, and no one mentioned Matthew freaking Lillard. And get this, he actually replied back saying, "Y'all, thank you for taking a small moment to shout this. It's kind, it's humbling, it's appreciated." Dude, I've seen the videos even of him online, and he's legit that good of an honest person. I think it's time to repot the cat. Yep, it's grown out of its little pot for a while. Need to get him replanted. I just saw a Reddit post by someone with extreme anxiety asking how to order a sandwich at Subway because they've never tried it, and someone replied and wrote out step-by-step instructions without being snarky or judgmental, and it's the kindest, sweetest thing I've seen in months. Ask my neighbor to look after my plant while I'm gone. He sent me this. Maybe that's a little too personal, but you know, they say you're supposed to talk to plants to make them grow anyway, so I guess he's on the right path. All right, folks, well, that is going to do it for us today. Hope you guys enjoyed those memes, and if you did, please give us a big thumbs up on this video. Subscribe to the channel for more content just like this, and don't forget to ding that notification bell so you never miss another content update from us. Until next time, folks, we'll be seeing you guys later.